Hello children, I am Sunandini Chegam, School Assistant Bioscience, GHS, Burgam Part. In earlier class, excretion part 1, we have studied the structure of kidneys, longitudinal section of kidney and the structure of the functional unit of kidneys, that is nephron. In this class, we shall study the formation of urine, dialysis and cadaver transplantation, and other accessory excretory organs. Now, take out your books, pen, and write down the important points which I tell in this part, as it is the most important part for examination, that is excretion part 2. Let me recall the parts of nephron. This is efferent arteriole, efferent arteriole, glomerulus, proximal convoluted tubule, distal convoluted tubule, Henle's loop, collecting tubule, and the most important, capillaries. These are the peritubular capillaries. Now, the mechanism of urine formation has four steps: glomerular filtration, tubular secretion, tubular reabsorption, and formation of concentrated urine. And the first step here is tubular filtration. Here the blood which flows into the glomerulus is filtered under high pressure due to the difference in the efferent and efferent arteriole. The diameter of the efferent arteriole is somewhat bigger than that of the efferent arteriole. Because of this narrowness, the pressure is exerted and the waste products present in the blood are filtered into the Bowman's capsule. The filtrate is known as primary urine, and this process is called glomerular filtration. Now, the next step is tubular reabsorption. The peritubular capillaries present around the Henle's loop and also the proximal convoluted tubule, they reabsorb the essential substances and excess water present in the primary urine. The primary urine from the Bowman's capsule will enter into the proximal convoluted tubule. There, the urine primary urine's excess of water and available salts are absorbed into the blood by the peritubular capillaries. So what happens next is tubular secretion. The blood that is present in the capillaries will secrete certain unnecessary waste materials like urea, uric acid, creatinine, potassium, calcium, sodium chloride and hydrogen salts back into the Henle's loop. This makes the blood pH and also urine's pH in balance, that is homeostasis. From there, it enters into the distance convoluted tubule. In the distance convoluted tubule, what happens is the urine becomes concentrated due to maximum reabsorption of the water and also essential salts. And this is done in presence of a hormone called vasopressin. This vasopressin helps in maximum reabsorption of water and essential salts. What happens if this vasopressin is not present in the blood? Excess of dilute urination, that is excess of dilute urine, will be passed from the blood of body of the patient, and this is called diabetes insipidus, and it can be recovered by administration of this hormone. Now let us see what is the composition of urine. The composition of urine depends upon the type of the food that we have taken. That is, if we take more proteinaceous food, it consists of more amount of amino acids, and they decompose and forms a urea content more in the urine. If we take lot of glucose rich food, it contains sugar, and sugar will be present in the urine of the patient even though he is not diabetic, and lot of fluid intake will pass a diluted urine, and generally it consists of 96% of water, 2.5% of organic substances like urea, uric acid, creatinine, vitamins, hormones, oxalates, etc., and 1.5% of inorganic solutes like sodium, chloride, phosphate, sulfate, magnesium, calcium, iodine, and pH of urine is 6, that is, it is like acidic in nature, but it becomes alkaline due to decomposition of urea into ammonia. Now, what is micturition? Passage of urine is called micturition, and urine is temporarily stored in the urinary bladder, and there are two set of sphincter muscles, circular in nature, and they are present in the bladder. They will control the passage of urine. When bladder is filled up, the pressure of urine will increase on the wall of the urinary bladder, and this causes the upper sphincter muscle to relax and open, but the lower sphincter muscle is under the control of brain. And we can still be retain urine because this muscle is under the control of brain, and it is not so in case of young children. It should be practiced to be voluntary. The control of urination is not done by the young children, but gradually they learn to pass it voluntarily. Urge for micturition occurs when bladder is filled with 300 to 400 ml of urine, but it can still store up to 700 to 800 ml. But at this time, when it is maximum filled, the urge for urination becomes painful and leads to voluntary micturition. Total amount of urine excreted will be 1.6 to 1.8 ml per day. Now you see the picture. A nurse is holding some glucose bottle, and some machine is there here. If you see, this is the glucose bottle. She is the nurse, and this is some machine. And here you can see the patient. Here you can see the patient, and some blood is being transferred through the pipes, cellophane tubes here. Now this is what happens if kidneys of a person won't function. The failure of the kidneys occurs. It is called end stage renal disease. If the kidneys fail, this you can see the machine there, that is called as the dialysis machine. This is the picture given to you in the textbook. Yes, the method that is used for cleaning of the blood of a diseased person whose kidneys are failed is called as the dialysis. Blood should be purified regularly, otherwise it occurs a disease called as uremia. This uremia, the patient's hands and legs will swell and also becomes very weak and cannot work, as purified blood is not present in his body. This is dialysis. Here blood is collected through artery of a patient, and it is passed through a dialyzer, and it consists of small cellophane tubes, and these are small cellophane tubes through which the blood flows. Blood flows, and here the liquid here, yellow color liquid here is the dialyzer. It is equal to that of the plasma and except that of nitrogenous waste. So as blood passes through these tubes, nitrogenous wastes present in the blood enters into the dialyzing liquid. So when blood is taken out through artery, anticoagulant called heparin is added, and the blood that is purified will be entered into the patient's body through a vein after adding an anticoagulant called heparin. Now you take out your pages and you note down the points. Now if both the kidneys fail, it causes the poisoning of our body with wastes, and it may lead to the death of the person. And a dialysis machine is used to filter the blood of a person when both kidneys are damaged. The process is called hemodialysis. Now you may get questions like, what happens if the kidneys of a patient are spoiled? Is there any method to filter off the nitrogenous wastes for a diseased person? What is hemodialysis? This type of patients may come for 2 or 4 marks, and you have to write out all these points. And in this process, blood is taken out from the main artery and mixed with an anticoagulant such as heparin, and then it is pumped into an apparatus called dialyzer. I have shown in the picture. And in this apparatus, blood flows through tubes which are made up of cellophane tubes, and these tubes are embedded in a dialyzing fluid. What is that fluid called? Dialyzing fluid. And the cellophane membrane separates the blood flowing inside the tube, and dialyzing fluid, which is same as the composition of plasma except the nitrogenous waste. They may ask the questions like, what is the difference between the dialyzing fluid and the plasma? You have to say the dialyzing fluid won't have nitrogenous wastes. As nitrogenous wastes are absent in the dialyzing fluid, and these waste substances from the blood will be removed into the fluid, then the blood becomes purified. This process is called hemodialysis, and clean blood is pumped back to the body after adding anticoagulant heparin. Dialysis process takes about 3 to 6 hours, and several patients are treated with this method. Nowadays it is available at low cost even in government hospitals. Now, what is there any permanent treatment for a completely diseased person whose kidneys are spoiled? Yes, there is, at least the kidneys transplantation. The best solution for failure of kidneys transplantation and the kidney of close relative or a person with same blood group or age of the patient is collected and transplanted to the diseased person. And in this picture you can see a kidney which is transplanted. Here these are the damaged kidneys. This is transplanted kidney, and this is the bladder. Yes, did you notice where the transplanted kidney is placed? Yes, it is in the lower part of the kidneys. Yes, you might have also watched on TVs that transplantation of heart has occurred, liver, and the person who donates organs are healthy person, or even a brain dead person who from whom the organs are taken are called as the donors, and the plantation is called as a cadaver transplantation. And let us, in your textbook an example is given for a person who gave Yes, for organ donation, you have example given in your textbook, Ashwant. Ashwant, he met with an accident and was brain dead. His organs were donated by his parents. His two kidneys, two valves, and liver was transplanted to another five people. And thus he is living in other five people again even after his death. Jeevan Dan scheme is a very good heartly campaign for living next time, that is for donation. We can also register our names and also our neighbors, our relatives' names. Immediately after that, they come and take the organs which we have donated so that we can live again. You will get for 2 marks questions. Write slogans on organ donation or write your opinion on cadaver transplantation. And are you ready to donate your organs? Be ready. And now, are there any other excretory organs in our body? Yes, there are accessory excretory organs. They are lungs, skin, liver, and large intestine. Lungs, they remove carbon dioxide and water vapor from our body, we know. And skin, it removes excess of water and salts in the form of sweat. Sebaceous glands eliminate sebum. You feel oily skin in summer season generally. That is nothing but the sebum which contains waxes, steroids, hydrocarbons and fatty acids. And the liver, the most critical excretory organ, it produces bile pigments, bilirubin, biliverdin and urochrome, which are metabolic wastes of hemoglobin of dead RBC. The lifespan of RBC is 120 days and they are destroyed in the liver and they are eliminated as bilirubin, biliverdin and urochrome. Urochrome is a low color pigment which is eliminated through urine. The color of urine is because of the presence of urochrome. Biliverdin and bilirubin are excreted out with bile. Cholesterol, steroids, hormones, extra drugs, the remnants of the tablets and extra vitamins, which are the remnants of the vitamin tablets that we have taken, and the salts are removed through bile juice. And now, urea formation occurs in the liver. And the next excretory organ is large intestine. Excess of calcium, magnesium and iron are excreted by epithelial cells of colon, which are eliminated with feces. And small amount of nitrogenous waste are eliminated through tears and saliva. Here are the pictures given in your textbook of lungs and skin and the liver and intestine, which are the accessory excretory organs. Now children, the 4 marks questions like write about dialysis, and 2 marks questions like write slogans on cadaver transplantation, and 4 marks question like the functioning of the nephron, or the questions like draw the diagram of nephron, label the parts, like that may come from this chapter. And now here is a video about the how the functioning of the kidneys will be there, and also about the functioning of the excretory system and nephron. Watch it and be ready for the third part of excretion, how it occurs in other animals and plants. Now you enjoy the video, children.
A pair of bean-shaped kidneys together receive around 25% of the blood pumped by the heart. Because it filters blood employing small filtration unit, nephrons, to remove toxic waste. inside the kidney. The outer deep red part named cortex is rich in blood capillaries and blood is filtered by nephrons Bowman's capsule in the cortex. The inner part, the medulla, is pale and this pyramid-like renal pyramids have bulk nephron tubules which carry the filtrate liquid. After reabsorption of essential materials in tubules, the liquid that reaches renal pelvis is urine. Ureter originates from renal pelvis. Ureter carry it to bladder for storing until the person urinates. Thus, kidney processes around 180 liter blood per day, producing 1 to 2 liter urine, assuming you drink minimum 3 liter water per day.